Tunks is back with me this afternoon from Meteoric Resources. Andrew, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Andrew. How are you?
Very good. Good to have you back, Andrew. Butcher's Creek met test work results, and you've seen some good recoveries here. Andrew, tell us a bit more.
Yeah. So we did a series of met test. The first thing you do in met test is you find out how hard it is and how it breaks. Good results there. Not too hard and breaks pretty easily. So that was the first thing. And then from there, you take that crushed ore and you do separate, different tests. So we did three tests. We did two with a gravity circuit up front. You know, gold is great for gravity. It weighs so much more than rock, about six times, so you can separate it out. We got fantastic results from the gravity work, over 97%. And that was, you know, that's a real bonus. What we also did then was a hole of ore. And that's simply where you crush the ore and you do a very standard cyanide leach. And for that, we got over 96% recovery. So the good news about that is gravity's great and often can give you better recoveries, but it, you know, there's additional capital costs, there's additional treatment, there's additional everything. So hole of ore, which is where you simply crush the rock and put it in the leach tanks with the cyanide, is the optimum if it's giving you the same sort of recoveries. And 97, 96, close enough for us. So we're very buoyed by not just the recoveries, but by the simplicity of the process.
So these results, Andrew, they all feed into a scoping study here.
That's right. So the scoping study is being done by Aurelia Mining Consultancy out of Perth, very familiar with, you know, the style of deposits and the costs and everything else. And they were the competent people on the recent resource upgrade that we did for Butchers. So that scoping study at this stage is really about how much of this will go in underground and how much will go in open pits. Now, open pits are the key. We know that the ore is right at the bottom of a historic open pit, and that will be the focus of the studies. And then can we model a high-grade cigar-like shoot going away from the open pits and into the underground? We're not expecting Butchers Creek to be a mine suddenly, but no doubt it will be mined at some stage. What this scoping study will do is talk about the economics of what we found so far and then really guide our exploration for next year. How much do we have to add, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And we've got some great exploration targets for next year. And importantly and crucially, we've just had a great set of meetings with the native title people up in the Kimberley Land Council and the traditional owners, and they've cleared all the work that we propose for next year. So that allows us to get out and really get into the exploration, which we've really only concentrated so far on Butchers, and there's a lot of other prospects that we haven't looked at yet.
Andrew, just while I've got you this afternoon, any news on Brazil? What's the latest here?
So Brazil is pending, as with Palm Springs, we're undergoing a scoping study in Brazil. We are taking the resource upgrade that we did during the middle of the year. We're looking at it in a different way. So it's possible, we haven't made our mind up on this yet, but we might have a new resource. We're looking at a larger, lower grade system, potentially modelling it that way and seeing how that looks. And then again, that will feed into a series of pits and a mill design, etc. We're more advanced in Brazil than we are at Palm Springs, and that's simply because of the grade of the ore is so much greater. And so you can have a very small plant, and there's a lot of these around in Brazil. There's a few going up in Alta Floresta at the moment and a few just to the north of us in the Tapajós. And we see that as a really successful model, those mines that are producing between 30 and 40,000 ounces per annum from small, high-grade ore bodies, exactly what we have. So we both those scoping studies, both Butchers Creek and Jarena, will report early in 2022. And they'll kick off what we expect to be a great 2022 after a really tough 2021. So bring it on is what we're saying, Andrew.
Good to see you, Andrew. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.